cast Dan Bongino, our good friend. All right, Dan, let's hit it. You know, he had quite a week. The guy's dealing with Iran, immigration. He's got his kickoff. And, I mean, and then the whole thing with Nancy Pelosi, she writes the note to Mr. President. Mr. President, we want a couple more weeks. Don't do the raids. Don't do them. What do you think the chances are of them putting something together with Congress to resolve what they should have resolved 14 years ago? More than 14.
Zero to none. I mean, Judge, they don't want to give President Trump any kind of a policy win on immigration.
So what are they doing for 2 weeks? Why did they take these 2 weeks?
Because they're just buying time, I don't know, to develop some counter plan to warn people here illegally. Who knows? I mean, I have no idea why they're trying to buy time. But the Democrats have made it clear that they're not willing to negotiate and that they're not willing to do a deal with this president, even if that deal would be better for all parties involved. Listen, Judge, no sane American wants to see this immigration crisis continue.
Horrible.
Nobody. But sadly, it works politically for the Democrats to keep it going because they can take pot shots at Trump. It's sad.
Well, it's very sad. And you know what's interesting? That they had planned to do these ICE raids, and all of these raids involve people against whom a judge has already issued a deportation order. All right? So these are people who've gotten the benefit of the doubt, even though they entered illegally, they're staying here illegally. I mean, a judge has ordered them out. But in addition to that, they're going to sanctuary cities to get them. But now you've got these sanctuary mayors like de Blasio and a bunch of others that we've heard about over the past year. I guarantee you they're planning some course of events in their sanctuary cities so that there's an automatic notice to everybody against whom a deportation order has been issued so that they're not in a position to be apprehended.
Well, Judge, that's what I didn't just make that up or pull that out of thin air when I said that before. I mean, we've seen the Oakland mayor, Libby Schaaf. We saw on a prominent Democratic congresswoman's Twitter account today, you know, warning people about this. Like you just said, these are not people who just crossed the border yesterday and claimed asylum. These are people who've been subjected to a judicial proceeding in the United States and have been ordered deported. They've got their due process, even though they're not even citizens, and they're still not leaving. This is not controversial unless you're an open borders type on the left.
Well, you know, and when Mexico, and I had spoken with Mark Morgan, Mexico finally agreed, and we'll see for how long, because I'm a skeptic. Mexico finally agreed, look, we'll hold these asylum people only after the president threatened the tariffs, all right, and Mexico's economy is in the tank. And now he threatens the Democrats and says, hey, look, we've got, and Mark Morgan is like hot to trot. They were going in all through the interior of this country starting tomorrow. She then says, we want to work with the president. We want to work with Congress. But the president is leveraging everybody. He is showing his strength without being the one, to declare war or to do all the things they've accused him of, which I'll talk about in my next open.
Well, sadly, it's the president versus just about everyone right now, Judge. There are some good folks. You said Jim Jordan on, Mark Meadows. They're excellent. And you have some decent Republicans on immigration, but they're very few. And here's the real problem, Judge. You know, a lot of Republicans in Congress are really Democrats, right? But no Democrats, zero, are really Republicans. So you have people on this issue who benefit, you know, some big business crowds and people who basically been bought off ideologically who have no interest in solving this immigration crisis at all. But Mark Morgan said it right. You solve Flores, this ridiculous 20-day guideline, and you can solve this problem or large parts of it tomorrow, but there's just no interest in doing it. It benefits them to attack the president on it.
Shame. Dan Bongino, thanks so much for being with us tonight. And Katrina Pearson still on deck, but Governor Mike Huckabee is next. To see if the Democrats and Republicans can get together and work out a solution to the asylum and loophole problems at the southern border. If not, deportations start. Here tonight to talk about all of this is the acting ICE director, Mark Morgan. All right, good evening, Mark. You know, Tomorrow was supposed to be this knockout. We're going into the interior of the United States and we are arresting everybody, families, it doesn't matter, where there is an order of deportation by a judge. It doesn't even matter if there is a criminal charge or a criminal conviction.
To protect them, but also to give Congress another chance on a bipartisan method to actually get together, pass this supplement so that we can enforce the rule of law, positively impact this crisis, and maintain the integrity of this system.
You know, I have to tell you, the American people are fed up. Every time we, like, hit the pedal, we pull back. Hit the pedal, we pull back. And you know what? The president, you know, I absolutely support him totally. When he put the leverage to Mexico, Mexico decided, look, we better...
Including families.
Yeah.
Something that the political will hasn't been there before.
Well, you know what? The political will of the American people is there. That we worry about the political will in Washington. Now, let me just ask you, unemployment. When Obama was 10%, so they're all continuing to come because they know they can get a job if they don't just want to live off of social services. So because this country is so great, so generous, so successful, they keep coming. You guys have to balance the scales for Americans. I want to ask you one more question. Now, when you release people to the interior, 90% don't come back to settle their asylum claim, which proves to me the claim of asylum was BS from the get-go. So, is there any way you can put an ankle bracelet on these people? Why are we just letting them into the interior?
So right now, we're forced to. There are two major elements that Congress could fix and they failed to do. The Florida Settlement Agreement, which says families, if you're a kid and you're a family, you have to be released. We have no alternative. We need to fix that. Congress needs to help us fix that. And so right now, that's what happens. And what we do is we don't just release them. We do put ankle bracelets on them. We give them information that they have to appear. But Judge, you know, they cut the bracelets off. They don't appear and they go into the winds into the interior United States, never to be heard from again. That's why ICE, we have to go after them. Look, we've tried everything to get them to come willingly to ICE to work with us. They have refused. We have no alternative. I don't want to go to their house. I don't want to go to their work site, but they've left us no alternative. They have refused again and again to comply with our laws of this country. They're forcing me to send men and women of ICE out to go and get them. I wish they wouldn't, but we have no choice.
Hey, that's real. They broke the law to get here, and they continue to break the law while they're here. Anyway, Acting ICE Director Mark Morgan, I look forward to having you on again. I want to finish this conversation. Maybe next week we can talk about how many people you arrested between tonight and next Saturday night. How's that?
Absolute,
deal?
Absolute deal.
All right.